color regular line drawings and create fabric mockups in Inkscape. An easy way this time. To start, we'll need black and white line drawing from the designer's website. I use Llama Hoodie by Itch to Stitch. Copy the image and paste it into Inkscape window. Path, trace bitmap to turn the image into vector. Trace bitmap is more art than science, lots of modes and parameters, some are better than others for particular images. I found that all defaults with brightness threshold around 0.7 are the best for line drawings. Now we have two objects on top of each other. I pull them apart, and if you open the objects panel, you'll see that one of them is a path, and another is the original image. You can delete the image now. To color the path, we need the individual parts inside. Path, break apart to separate them. It turns black, but you can see lots of selection rectangles inside. Click outside to remove the selection. Hold shift and click each of black shapes to select them. Then click some bright color in the bottom. Drop the selection to the bottom with a panel button or press end, and here they are, our lines. Each black shape is an individual path we can color. If you are working with solids only, that was really easy. But we really need a fabric mockup, right? Return to the browser for fabric photos or create your own. I go to knitfabric.com and copy some pretty fabrics. Paste the image into Inkscape. For the sake of simplicity, I won't scale them to real size. There is no ruler, so I couldn't anyway. I just scale the image down for our hoodie to fit. If you'd like more tutorials, consider subscribing and make suggestions for the future topics in the comments. With Shift, click all the pieces you intend to sew with this watermelon fabric. You can color them to see if you've got them all. Then path, you need to make them one path and cut our fabric. I color the resulting path so you can see better. It's prettier this way too. Pull the new path on top of the fabric. If it disappeared like mine, put it on top with a button or press home. With shift, add the fabric to the selection. Object, clip, set to hide all the fabric that wasn't covered by our path. It looks like all of it disappeared, but it's just under. Click away to remove selection, pull the colored path away, and here it is, our fabric. Pull it back on top of the line drawing and align in place. We'll do the same for other fabrics we want to use. There is an easy mistake to make at this step. Select all the pieces, forget to union them and bring in a new fabric. Selection is lost after this, and you'll have to select all the pieces again. To avoid this, bring all the fabrics in at once or color and union all the parts at the same time. I only show this fabric after fabric for demonstration purposes. Here I select all the pieces, or I'm thinking I've selected them all. It's a common mistake too, so I'll leave it and show you how to fix this mishap later. Previewing the pieces by coloring them should help with this, in theory. You can see this didn't save me. To make the hoodie mockup look better, zoom in and select the bottommost path, the one we colored brightly. Select some darker gray for it now to blend it in. Mine is some dark olive because my favorite Inkscape palette doesn't have any neutral colors, probably that's why it's my favorite. Here we came to the missing piece. If you realize you have missed a piece after clipping, it's an easy fix. Duplicate the cut fabric and pull it aside, then treat it as a new fabric. I assume the pieces you could forget would be small and will fit. If they don't, object, clip, release, make all the fabric visible again. Clipping is just masking, really. You can also mask groups. Say if you duplicate several pieces of fabric to get a bigger one, you'll see them all in the objects panel. Unlike cutting the fabric, it's fully reversible. I've made all these views using the same method, well, one of them I simply colored. It's easy, quick, and results aren't bad at all.